limited and workshop space for anyone to come in and public to move in that area. The site was in a very small plot. It was a 30 by 40 plot, and the program was also considerably small. We had only two studios and guest rooms to be built in this area. This allowed us to question a much larger, or explore a much larger question. Looking at Bangalore, the kind of development it has seen over few decades, one wonders what is the kind of requirement the city has in terms of its materials, and where does it get the materials from? So, to get the answer, one doesn't have to travel much. The answer is in the vicinity of the site itself. The large quarries around the city are giving the material for this greed of the city dwellers. The kind of devastating impact it has on the landscape around the city is quite disturbing. So can we look at another place? Can we look at a different source of material? Can we look at what is right under? Can we look at what is right under our feet? Can we look at our site as quarries for material? So given this in mind, what we thought was to put in the main function of the school, that was the dance studio, to be taken in the basement. So the basement provided for the soil. So this basement was lit by the two courtyards in the front and back. And the height of the basement provided for the light and ventilation all across the building. The basement provided for 185 cubic meter of soil, which was very good for making stabilized mud blocks. These blocks were made by local labor and manually without causing any pollution in terms of air or sound. The walls were made with these blocks available at the site. Even the roofs were built using the same block precast arch panels. The soil was in fact so much that it allowed for building another building south of Bangalore. It provided the soil enough for making the entire building walls as well as the roof for the other building as well. This kind of collaborative, cooperative approach of building provided material for not only one but two buildings in the same city. Most of the cities, what we see in India and around the world, face a large issue of managing their waste. This waste then lands up in the low-lying areas or the areas which have the lake catchment areas or the floodplains which were earlier giving respite from the flood, the urban flood which have caused. So this kind of a dumping of the waste in these areas causes damage to the ecology. At the same time, it causes more problems in terms of the urban flooding. The waste which is generated during this construction of buildings, as well as during the demolition of the building, where does it go? Is there a solution for this problem? Can our buildings stop becoming a part of the problem and give a solution for our problems? Keeping this in mind, a sculptural wall was built inside the building to take in the waste which would be generated during the construction of the building. This wall was built from the blocks which are broken during the construction and filled with the construction debris concrete. The surface was then finished with mud plaster to become a backdrop for the staircase which is skirting around it. The roof of the building was made from the Tetra Pak waste sheets, which were very lightweight material. This reduced the weight of the structure and at the same time offset for the waste which will be generated by the building's user in future. The story doesn't end here. Making a building socially and ecologically responsible is as important as making it a beautiful looking and a user-friendly building. The site, which was a 30-40 site, didn't offer much in terms of views from the surrounding areas. The only breather which was the tree in front of the building. The whole design was based on the introvert design and the building making its own views. Interconnected courtyards at different levels provided for a more communicative space during the performances. The performance area, the music studio, was opened up during larger events, and the staircases and passages at the upper level became the seating areas. As Ms. Thomas Cupid said, we are only as big as the question we address, and this, to my mind, is the central limiting fact of life for architects. Not size or value of the project we are working on, but the nature of the question they raise and which we must confront. A chance to prove the abiding virtue of the person itself.
It's quite interesting, especially the effort you have taken to make you so far the construction level you have reached. The material renovation of power transfer making moving with material traffic is a beautiful idea. But architecture is supposed to be the greenest architecture must be the one that stands for what we need. The durability of structure. So, no, making such a tetra pack roof product. Now, what will be the life of such things? Number one. The second question is, of course, it's a narrow plot. But why don't you give some time around the opening for inviting the people into that structure? Because that opening is in your design.
To answer the first question, the material which is used for roofs, one, it would have anyways landed up in the waste landfills. So this is giving it a second life, the waste which would have been already generated. It's giving it a different purpose, and as per the manufacturers, we've used this only 6 years back, so we don't know what would be the life expectancy, but as per the manufacturers, it should have at least 20 to 25 years of life. Yeah. To answer the second question, yes, the site constraint sort of had a role to play in not making it a very open to outside space. But yeah, we'll take it.
Good morning. It's not really a question that maybe a remark. You are talking a lot about materials and your ecological the problem. And I would say that all that is of course very important, more and more important. But it is material, it is process, and architecture is what we're going to do with that. And I would say you didn't explain much the concept of the house. You passed a lot of time speaking about the process. So the process is one thing, but you must get to something that too, and this architecture, and you should explain them. So it is the first.
To answer that question, I'd love to talk about the concept of it. So, yeah, I'll get it short. So, there are three. Yes, there are. So, there were three programs basically. One was the dance studio, which was in the basement. So, the whole basement was sucked down to get the material and also to reduce the scale of the building, because it was going to be a very high ceiling, 15 feet tall building. And when we had only 30 feet plot in the front, the building would have gone very tall. So, that was good. That's why it was brought into the bottom. The music studio, which was in the middle, was connected to a courtyard in front so that it becomes a performance space, and the open area in front on the upper level becomes an area where people can sit and enjoy the performances. And top were the places where two guest rooms were built for the performers when they come and stay.
Generate theory of the whole healing process. That's a very interesting concept. But one of the solutions that you did for that was to actually lose some floor area by making a tomb for that construction material in the form of that curved wall. Yeah. How did you arrive at such a decision? Because it's already a small site in space, and you lost more space by actually doing your construction based in that curved wall.
That wall is okay, it's a feature wall to show that what in a beautiful way debris can be used, but at the same time it's a structural wall, it's not a freestanding wall. It supports the roof above and the gallery which is there, it also...
But it's about a meter thick.
The wall at the broadest part would be about 2.5 feet, and to the narrowest point it's 3 meters.
And you lose that
for
space.
Yes.
Thank you.